Well, President Marcos downplaying the controversial photos of government officials with Alice Goh, the chief executive, chalking it up to the country being the selfie capital of the world.
That is part of the new culture now. Na nagpapakuha lagi ng kahit ano. Kasi po-post nila. Tignan mo, nakasama ako dito sa team na nag-aresto sa ganyan-ganyan. That's ang tawag natin sa Pilipinas, we are the selfie capital of the world, di ba? Hindi nag-selfie, hindi mo naman pigilan ng tao na ngumiti. So, they just had a selfie. I don't think there's much more to it than that.
Meanwhile, the president is hoping Alice Goh will finally reveal what she knows about the criminal activities of POGOs.
What I want to hear from her is for her to lay out exactly how these POGOs became so such a large, it's basically a criminal enterprise. And as mayor, for her to say she did not know this was going on, it's very difficult to believe. Because as a former local government executive, it seems impossible that an operation that is what a few hundred meters away from my own office, na hindi ko alam yung nangyayari doon, illegal na ganitong kalaki na operation. Kaya sana maipaliwanag niya kung bakit hindi niya alam. Marami pa siyang kasagutin. Paano siya yumaman ng ganyan? Ba't ang dami-dami ng pera? Paano siya naging mayor na hindi naman siya kilala ng tiga doon? I just hope she answers it better than her cohorts. Sina Cassandra Ong at saka sina Sheila Ong, very evasive makasagot. Sana naman mabuti-buti ang sagot ni Alice Goh as compared dun sa mga kasamahan niya. Because it will not help her at all to be evasive. Mas bibigat ang magiging problema niya kung hindi siya magsabi ng totoo.
Senator Rizzo Ontiveros, meanwhile, reminds government officials Goh is a criminal, not a celebrity.
We want answers, not a photo shoot. Matapos niyang makipagtaguan sa batas, ginawa namang fan meet nitong si Alice Goh ang pagka-aresto niya. Kulang na lang red carpet. Tingnan natin kung gaano siya ka-photogenic sa hearing sa Lunes. Only pictures siya doon. Isang paalala rin sa ating mga kasamahan sa gobyerno. Hindi dapat ginagawang social event ang pag-aresto sa isang puganting sangkot sa patong-patong na kaso ng human trafficking, money laundering, fake identity at gross misconduct. Pinaglaruan ni Alice Goh ang mga batas ng Pilipinas at ginamit niya ang posisyon niya para makapag-operate ang mga POGO na naging sangkot sa kidnapping, murder, human trafficking at prostitution. Alice Goh, the fake Filipino, will have a lot of explaining to do on Monday. Pagbabayaran niya ang pagsisinungaling niya, ang pagtago at takas at ang panloloko sa sambayan ng Pilipino.
Indonesian authorities have released video of Alice Goh's actual arrest in Indonesia. In that clip, which you're about to see, local police and immigration officers are seen arresting the dismissed town mayor in her rented apartment in Tangerang City late Tuesday. Goh's arrest came as Indonesian authorities initiated a crackdown on fugitives to clear possible threats during Pope Francis's visit. Dismissed Mayor Alice Goh has been taken to the regional trial court in Kapas, Tarlac after she was deported from Indonesia early Friday. Our very own Johnson Manabat now joins us with details. Johnson, what can you tell us?
Hi, Carmina. Good afternoon. This is Ms. Banban Tarlac Mayor Alice Goh arrived here in Kapas, Tarlac to face the judge who issued the arrest warrant against her for two counts of graft and corruption charges, which is a bailable offense. The Philippine National Police escorted a former mayor from Kamkram in Quezon City and arrived in Kapas around 11:25 this morning. Former Mayor Goh is wearing a white hoodie jacket, escorted by police personnel, and went straight to the Sala of Kapas RTC Branch 109 at the second floor of one of the buildings in the municipality of Kapas. The charges against Goh stem from a case filed by the DILG in June, accusing her of violating the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. Based on the warrant issued by the judge, the total bail is set at 180,000 pesos or 90,000 pesos per count. It is not yet clear if the judge will issue a commitment order whether Goh will be returned back to the PNP Custodial Center in Quezon City or whether she will be detained in other detention facilities. So any moment from now, we are expecting that Google exit the RTC judge, the RTC branch 109, and security is very tight as of the moment. So we'll be back after a few minutes for any update here in Capas, Tarlac. Carmina.
All right, Johnson, just a couple of questions for you before we let you go. What are the expectations? Is she expected to post bail? If she does post bail, what's happened next? What will happen next? If she does not post bail, will she be detained there in Tarlac?
We haven't talked to the lawyers of Go, but based on our interview over Teleradio last night, Attorney Stephen David said that he is not advising her client to post bail because she will be detained in the Senate because she's also facing Warren Varez at the upper house. Carmina.
Okay, so if she, even if she does not post bail, they will still adhere to the earlier commitment that she be detained at the Senate. Is that clear?
Carmina, sorry, I can't hear you.
Is she, if she does not post bail, does that mean that she will still be detained at the Senate as what was earlier agreed upon?
Yes, yes, Carmina, she still be detained whether she post bail or not because whether she post bail for 180,000 pesos, she will also be detained at the Senate because she is facing another warrant of arrest. From the Senate of the Philippines.
Okay, all right. We're going to have to leave it at that. We're going to wait for more updates from your very own Johnson Manabat there, close on the trail of dismissed Mayor Alice Go, who is on her way to Capas, Tarlac. She is going to be taken to the regional trial court there in Capas, Tarlac, under very strict security. Johnson Manabat there joining us on the line. Nearly 90 illegal Chinese POGO workers caught here in the Philippines deported to China this morning. The workers were apprehended in raids on POGO scam hubs in Bamban, Tarlac and in Porac, Pampanga. The Philippines has so far deported over 1,700 foreign nationals involved in illegal POGO operations, with 300 Chinese nationals still awaiting deportation.